my mother was and father were both important to me in many ways, not only as giving birth, having me as a child, but they were just wonderful people. My mother was a, I've told this many times, but my mother was the daughter of a poor immigrant Italian family who could not afford to buy her a winter coat one year when she was in high school, so she had to drop out of high school. But she was continued, they did, a teacher who loved my mother continued to educate her on the side, Miss Carroll, I know her as, who admired my mother. And my mother later became very educated, self-educated. She was a, she became a socialist and voted for Norman Thomas every time he ran the socialist candidate.
That's why Bob sympathized with the social planners.
That's right, undoubtedly. She was a pacifist, and she thereby then became a member, a Quaker, member of the Society of Friends. I was never sent to a public school because in those days you had to pledge allegiance to the flag. She thought that was coercive patriotism. So I always went to a private school. But on the other hand, despite all that, she had enormously good taste. She was very interested in dressing well, which usually you don't think of a socialist woman as going that way. And the furniture that I grew up with my mother and father, that they bought when they were married was just, and is just fabulous furniture that I very much considered the house when I designed it as a setting for the existing furniture that they had, and there are pictures of that to acknowledge the way it was. And I think she was very happy living in the house. I think she was happy with it. My father had died by then. And it soon became a place where lots of young architects came to visit the house from all over. And she was happy to show them through and give them a lecture on me as a child and other things, maybe about socialism.
The architecture of the house and the babyhood of its architect.
God knows. But anyhow, it was a very nice experience to work with that client who was absolutely sympathetic and understanding.
Tell them about your father.
My father, I learned a while back from a historian in Philadelphia who referred to the fruit store designed by Phineas Paste in 1909 for Robert Venturi. My father was a fruit merchant. His family came here. He also was born in Italy, but came here. They started a fruit store, and they were poor at the beginning. In the end, he became quite prosperous. The fruit store became
wholesale.
Became wholesale, mm-hmm. where he produced, delivered fruit to restaurants, to hotels, to universities, to institutions, hospitals. And anyhow, I said, how could that be? At 1909, my father was only something like 28 years old, and Phineas Paste was a very famous and establishment architect. He was one of the architects to design the Bellevue Stratford Hotel in Philadelphia. But then I said, he was a friend, and my father was a friend of all the architects in Philadelphia at that time, mm-hmm. even though he was never finished high school and was a fruit merchant. He wanted to be an architect. The building was never built that he designed for my father. But eventually, there was a warehouse designed for my father in 1922 when it was a wholesale business, and that was designed by a well-known a local architect named Edwin Brumbaugh. They both loved architecture. He wanted to be an architect, and they probably influenced me directly and indirectly. But from the very beginning, I wanted to be an architect. I can never remember when I did not want to be an architect. I can still drive through streets that were on the way to kindergarten when I went to kindergarten and point out my favorite buildings along the way, houses that I liked.